Welcome to CLD Movie Maker. CLD Movie Maker presents CLD Bible Study. So now, we will do this for the show of God, you know. So now, we are going to talk about the types of love. Yes, so the types of love. So what are the types of love? So the question of the day is, what love looks like? So what love looks like? Maybe, let's just imagine something. What love looks like? Oh, okay, later we will answer that question. So now we will talk about the types of love. So the first type of love is the romantic love or the eros love. God says the romantic love is reserved for marriage. Eros love should be the opposite sex, man and woman. It leads to children, family, joy, and laughter, like creating a complete family. It is usually between a man and a woman. It can be platonic and extend to deep, intimate friendships. So we're going to read 1 Corinthians 7:5.
1 Corinthians 7:5. Do not deprive one another except perhaps by agreement for a limited time that you may devote yourselves to prayer, but then come together again so that Satan may not tempt you because of your lack of self-control.
Hey, we're back. So it means a happy family in heaven. But God desires each family to experience happiness for all the aspects of our lives. It like holding hands, expression of feelings, and romantic love. Then spiritual blessing of love has received. So we receive the love that God has given us. So to come again and defeat Satan. So tatanong din natin si Satan. So next, the next is family love or the storge love. Yeah, the pronunciation of storge love. Like me, yes, I confess, I also have shortcomings of our family. Example, I answer back to my parents, like I'm hurting my parents, I will try my best to change. But it's so hard for me to change because yun na yung nakasanayan ko, or that's what I am talaga. So I will try my best, and I'm like, somehow I'm hurting your feelings, so that's why I'm answering back to them, because they also hurt my feelings. Anyone, we have all shortcomings in our family. May pagkukulang tayo sa pamilya. Wala naman perfect ng pamilya eh. May pagkukulang din tayo sa family natin. So now we are going to talk about family love or storge love. It means affectionate bond between parents and children, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters. This is the love of community and family, often beautiful. It is natural but powerful enough to be hindrance to spiritual growth. We will read Romans 12:10, and Romans 12:10 says,
Romans 12:10, love one another with brotherly affection, outdo one another in showing honor.
So we're back. So now it means, Romans 12:10 says, or it means loving dearly, being devoted, and being very affectionate. Loving the way of characteristic of the relationship between the husband and the wife, mother and child, father and son. That's the explanation of Romans 12. And always remember in our minds that when we become the followers of Jesus Christ, we enter also the family of God. Always remember, if you're a follower of Jesus Christ, you're also family of God. We are all families. So if you're Catholic or Christian or naniniwala sa Diyos talaga, naniniwala ka, hey, Heavenly Father, we are all families. And the third is to feel the love or the friendship love. It means brotherly love. So it's about the friendship you feel towards people like you, with the same interests, the social ways and style. God said to have the kind of love like this or for us and Jesus. So it means God says this kind of love is for us and Jesus. So para sa atin ito lahat, yung love na feel niya. Lahat naman tayo may friends. Wala naman tao na walang friend. Kasi sabi ni Jesus, He is our best friend. So, yun. So may best friend na tayo si Jesus. And Father natin, si Heaven or si God. So we will read Proverbs 18:24.
One who has unreliable friends soon comes to ruin, but there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother.
So, okay, actually, this situation happens already to my life. I became unreliable to my friends. I've been close to them like my real friends, but sometimes I break their trust. So this verse means, if you break their trust, your friendship will be ruined. But there is also a friend who sticks closer than a brother. So this means, mababalik mo yung friendship. Like example, you ruin your friendship, mababalik din. Pero meron pa mas maano na friendship na darating sa iyo. Or yung friend mo dati, yung magiging closer mo siya more than a brother. So yun. It also means that we need to choose your friends carefully. Yes, this is true, Mama. We need to choose our friends carefully. So there is a message about friends. So friends come and friends go. But true friends sticks by you like a family. So there. And lastly, my favorite love. Everyone's favorite or not? Yeah. The agape love, or called God's love. Everyone knows that God's love is very important to our lives. Yes. So agape is the highest of the four types of love in the Bible. The term defines God's immeasurable, incomparable, unconditional, sacrificial love, and pure God love of God. God gives this love without condition. We all know this verse. For the agape love is John 3:16, or our verse is John 3:16. So everyone knows John 3:16. So this is the verse of John 3:16.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not be perished but have eternal life.
So John 3:16 means, everyone knows this already, God loves you so much, and He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to be born on earth and die on the cross. But God made the way. Christ lived a perfect, blameless life and provided a perfect sacrifice for our sins. So, nagsakripisyo si Jesus para sa mga kasalanan natin. That's why He died on the cross. The cross. So He sacrificed. So agape love is a love of supreme and greatness. So it is a love of supreme and greatness. Okay, so we are done already in the four types of love. And now we will answer the questions of the day. So now we will answer the question, what love looks like? So now, what love looks like? There's the video that I will show you.
What does God love look like? So that's our question of the day. So the answer is, God loves looks like Jesus. Why? It is because Jesus' love is undeserved. Jesus' love is compassionate. Jesus' love is sacrificial. Jesus' love is caring. Jesus' love is patient. Jesus' love is personal. Jesus' love is inclusive. Jesus' love is complete. Jesus' love is forever. Jesus' love is selfless. And of course, friend, Jesus loves you completely.
Okay. Remember this verse. Before we end up the show, the verse of the day is Philippians 4:8. And now, here is this message of Philippians 4:8.
The last is, or the verse of the day is Philippians 4:8. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things.
So Philippians 4:8 is already our verse of the day. So now, shout this to everybody. Shout it to the world. Shout it to God. Shout it to Jesus. And rejoice by this message. Jesus loves me just because He chooses to love me. So I repeat, Jesus loves me just because He chooses to love me. So I will shout it to the universe already. Jesus loves me just because He chooses to love me. So every time I hear this message, I'm rejoicing, or I'm happy. Happiness is something you make happen. So okay, thank you for watching, and please like the video or subscribe. So thank you.